Hey there everybody, Shadefire here, and today I'm taking a first impressions look at Far Cry 4, because I was playing through Far Cry Primal, obviously, and eventually I finished it sometime this year, and right around when I finished it, Far Cry 4 was on sale, and you know, I enjoyed Far Cry Primal, even though it was the typical Ubisoft bloated open world game with way too much pointless bullshit to do, but I was like, yeah, you know, I wouldn't mind playing another Far Cry game with guns, because as much fun as it is clubbing mammoths to death, having to run up to every single person you want to kill is just a pain. I mean, there was bows, but, you know, being able to just point and shoot just feel good again. So, I bought this while it was on sale. It's like 20 bucks or something. Thought that was a decent price, and I've been enjoying it so far. It is definitely more Far Cry. Oh, I don't want to do online. Don't want some rando popping in, because the co-op is kind of shitty in this game, from what I understand, since you can only get a certain distance away from your co-op partner, like this is a PS2 split-screen game or something. Like, the shitty, hidden co-op mode in San Andreas, where you couldn't get too far away from each other because you couldn't handle the loading. There's no reason for that on PC. Oh man, you didn't see it there because it was right when it popped in, but it loaded in and everything was just a black void with some glowing windows, and then the world came in. So yeah, you know, it's Far Cry. It's an open world game, you do missions for people, you clear outposts of enemies, which then become friendly outposts. Honk at me. And you collect a bunch of shit, and you get new guns, and you upgrade your guns, and you drive around. The map here is pretty big. Some people say that the map in Far Cry Primal was just reused from this one, but changed slightly, but if that's the case, I haven't really noticed, aside from it's kind of mountainy and hilly. But this is a sort of fake Tibet country, you know, in the Himalayas, and you're part of a resistance against the horrible dictator, who is also probably your father. Because there's a alternate ending you can do if you basically don't do the thing the game tells you to do at the beginning. But, yeah, so fighting a dictator, you don't really have any sort of stake in this. You just kind of show up one day and they're all like, oh, your father was the leader of the resistance, so now you have to lead, because it's your duty. And you're like, I just came here to spread my mom's ashes per her final request. And they're like, oh yeah, we'll totally help you do that. But, you know, that place you want to go is, it's right next to the stronghold of the warlord, so, you know, you help me, I'll help you. That sort of situation where you can clearly tell that everyone is just taking advantage of you, as is the case in most Far Cry games. Another reason I wanted to do a first impressions for this game is so you can see my amazing, atrocious driving, which I feel like I don't get a chance to showcase in a lot of games I do. What are we doing here? There's a supply drop. I believe this will trigger a mission, or a side mission. Honey Badger. That's probably overkill. I think I might need some Honey Badger skin. Of course, this still has the Far Cry 3 crafting thing. Oh, geez, eagle. The eagles are coming. But yeah, it still has the whole thing of kill animals, get their skin, make bigger ammo cases and stuff. This is very much Far Cry 3 version 2. Oh. That's not what I want to do. So it's been a little while since I actually played this, so I'm trying to remember the weapon switch quick thing. Right, I don't have a fourth slot, that's why I can't switch to it. Oh, I miss every single shot. Alright, here comes some bros. Shotgun to the face. Not so good. Oh, and I don't have any healing items, so it does the bloody little animation where you pop a bullet out with a stick. Alright, that was not a good way to start. Alright, let's just grab this fucking supply drop and get out of here.
Go ahead.
Ajay, some packages were dropped in your area. Sending you the coordinates now. We need you to grab the packages before the governor's men do.
You got it.
Alright. So yeah, we just need to go pick something up and then drive it back. Well, not back here, but back to the guy. So let's go. And we don't need roads where we're going. See, I think the big problem with driving in games is I like to make my own path. And in games like this, that often leads to getting your car impaled on top of a tree, or just driving off a cliff and dying. Oh, I totally could have ramped off that tent. Oh, there's a thing here. This is one of the packages, right? I hear something beeping. Oh, jeez. What are these guys called? They're something that starts with a D.
Yeah.
It's a. Should tell them here. Doles?
Yeah,
the D holes. Which is obviously not how you pronounce it. Alright, here's the package.
Got the first one.
Good work. One more to go. Carefully now.
Easy enough so far. I can't believe they lost one of their supply drops. Oh, there's a gyrocopter. We don't need that shit. I can drive there just fine. This car's gonna fucking explode. I think I wedged it. I don't think it's moving. Oh. Come on, baby. You know you want it. No, I think it's fucked. Well, it's not the worst wedge job I've ever done. Yeah, it looks like we've got the axle stuck. How's that gyrocopter doing? Oh, it flipped over. Alright, we can flip it over again. Up and over. Now, let's see if I can remember how to use this thing. Basically, it doesn't really function like a helicopter because if you hit the if you hit its ceiling, it just kind of breaks. So you have to kind of stay low. Yeah, there's an outpost over there. You can tell because of the black smoke. Coming in for a landing. Can I get back up here if I jump down? That guy's dead. Should be able to land on this guy. Those are always fun to do. Jump stabs. Somebody behind me. Here comes the reinforcements. Got something for that. Problem solved. I guess we should probably do a story mission too, but, you know, this is one of those games where it's fun to just kind of dick around and do side objectives.
And that's the last one. What's in these?
Oh, right.
Never mind that. Just drop them off at this location, quick!
Yeah, I don't think we can get back on the roof. Oh, I might be able to... I might be able to jump in. Let's just drive there, then. Hopefully I won't fuck this car up. Nope. We're already here.
Are you sending the supplies to the Golden Path?
Not yet.
They're stockpiling them for an operation. I can't say any more than that.
I'm going to shoot your face off!
Alright, side mission completes.
Hey! Hold on, hold on!
So let's see here. Let's go do a mission, I guess. Usually the missions are good at mixing up the game, so it's not just the same thing you're doing during side missions of running around shooting dudes. Alright, Sabal, and there was another one around here somewhere. Could have sworn I saw another letter. B. Badra. So there's also this sort of mechanic where there are two opposing leaders of this thing. Not really opposing, but, you know, they both have their own way of doing things, and it's like, oh, help out this person, you'll gain more respect with them, and eventually one of them will become the leader, and it's I'm never really big on those systems. I prefer to play both against each other than have to pick sides. But I guess we'll go... Do I have anyone else? What's this? It's a fortress mission. So you can do these fortresses at any time, but the idea is they get easier the farther you go into the campaign, I guess. Alright, well, Sabal is over here. Let's go do his, I guess. Alright, so this is an outpost I've taken over, so we can just fast travel here. Let's see... I just want to change my weapons if there's a thing to do that here. Maybe it's just here. Refill ammo. That. I sell all my junk. So yeah, there's a bunch of junk items you pick up, and those are basically just to sell. For money. Let's see. Yeah, so these are the ones I already have. Using the 1911 right now. But let's equip the scorpion, I guess. Just want to see what I have to play with here. Okay, let's take a shotgun instead of... Yeah, we don't need the RPG, I don't think. Pretty sure I was using that specifically for a destroy vehicles mission. I wouldn't like that 1887 shotgun. You can see too that there's multiple ways to unlock them. It's either just play through the game and eventually you'll get it for free, or just clear X amount of objectives and you'll get it for free. So that's neat. Or you could just buy them. Alright, so Sabal is just down the road, so let's drive there. See? The most direct route is always the fastest. Until you get stuck. No, we're good.
Following is an announcement from the Ministry of Homeland Protection.
And if you actually do want to reuse a vehicle instead of just dumping it, you can repair it. Which the glass just sort of fuses back together. I do miss the dopey car repair animation from Far Cry 2, where you just open the engine up and twist a little bolt on it, and that fixes it.
Sabal. A champion returns. Defending that rebel camp saved a lot of lives.
You guys put me in a difficult position.
Amita would have let our people die, and for what? For intel that we may or may not have needed? The right choice was obvious, brother. It's what your father would have done. That's the golden path. That's the direction we were going before Moen died. That's why I stepped up. Because I knew your father, and I respected his vision.
And where does Amita fit into all of this?
Look, I'll be the first to give her credit. but you don't need two hands. Not if you want to get work done. That's something your father taught me. You need to learn what drove him, what drives us. Go to the monastery.
Now, this might be a drug trip mission, which not quite exactly what most of this game is like, but, you know. You've kind of already seen the main sort of gameplay this has. Just go around, murder dudes, pick up stuff, make money. Let's see, pull up the map here. Can we do that in the car? It was tab, but I guess that is actually the weapon wheel. Oh, that's a syringe thing. It's not what I want.
Uncle Pagan here, just checking in on my favorite nephew. So tell me, RJ, who are you rooting for so far? Have you fallen into Amitar's honeypots, or have you been dazzled by Saval's flowing locks and bad boy jawline? Hey, each to his own. That's your lifestyle choice to make. He isn't my cup of tea, contrary to the rash assumptions some may make about my appearance. I am indeed batting for the other team. You more than most should know that there was only ever one woman for me, my boy.
And that's the big bad Pagan man who likes to call you and chat you up. Stopped here because there's a collectible, as you can hear that humming sound. There is an evil mask here somewhere. Left here by this guy. Who worships some god of darkness and is a serial killer. I assume this will eventually go somewhere if you pick up enough of these damn things.
Same as before.
That doesn't help me. I can hear it. It's here somewhere. It's on the roof?
The enemy
I just want to see if I can kill this guy with this repair tool. See, it's so easy to get distracted by just random stuff happening. Alright, is this mask on the roof? Oh, that's it there. What's our healing situation? This is not what I want. I can't remember how to bring this menu up, which I guess you can't do when you're driving. Okay, skill points. I have 4 skill points. I guess I should unlock something. A lot of these skills really don't seem that useful. I guess we'll ride elephants. Just unlock these skills. I wanted to see. What did I want to see? I can't even remember now. I don't know, I've totally forgotten. You know, I think I wanted to see how far that outpost was, to see if I should figure it on the way.
The following is an announcement from the Ministry of Communication. Radio towers in Kyrat are the sole property of Pagan Min. Tampering with these towers is a serious offense. If you
Sadly, in this case, I don't think we can take a more direct route since there's a mountain in the way. Oh, I almost plowed right through them thinking they were troops. This is either going to be real sweet, or it's going to be instant death. Oh, never mind. I thought there was going to be a cliff here.
The following is an announcement from the Ministry of Public Affairs and Social Harmony. Interfering with official Royal Army operations...
Nope, never mind. Nothing up there.
Those found guilty of insurgent acts face summary sentencing and execution.
Oh, god damn it, Uplay popped me out of the game there. For some reason, whenever this thing does something to do with Uplay, it will either minimize your game or change from full screen to non-full screen, or the opposite. It's weird. This is one of those games that has that bullshit always online DRM. Where you have to be logged into Uplay just to play it. Not logged into Uplay, but you have to be logged in game as well.
Hey, Ajay! How've you been?
That's quite the monk outfit.
He's a good man. He just doesn't like idiots. But once you get to know him...
Yeah, but do
Namaste!
Alright, I think we're gonna go on a journey here. Which is not something new, because, you know, Far Cry 3 had this as well.
Sabal tells me you're
and Far Cry Primal also has it. Your father liked to get really high.
God of gods sang the world into existence. For that, we give him thanks. We thank the gods for giving us life. Please, take an offering basket.
I guess we just have to be a good guy and get some karma here.
A candle reminds us that growth only comes with a willingness to step beyond our usual boundaries.
That goat doesn't seem to give much of a shit. Karma wheel.
The gods bless us with wisdom, and we collect them in the prayer wheel to purify ourselves from bad thoughts. Spin the wheel. Life without emotion is no life at all, but a life controlled by emotion is to be consumed by it. Add the powder. Life is as tenuous and fleeting as a wisp of sweet-smelling smoke. The incense represents our mortality.
What are the breadsticks for? Not those, but the hit in the basket.
Please, leave the basket here.
Oh, all right. Give me back your basket of offerings. I'm here, Raju.
Hello, Ajay.
Sabal speaks highly of you. He asked you be allowed to see this. Yalum, the great demon, resides in all people. He brings false promise and burns hope.
The goat dies to keep Yalung asleep and sated.
Can I skin the goat?
We are a spiritual people. Your father understood, but more than that, he inspired others by his deeds. Think hard on what you see, Naji.
Is that all? You're gonna give me some special incense, and I'm gonna go on a journey. A journey of the mind.
Namaste.
No, I guess we're not. We're just gonna leave. Oh, and now the monster is under attack, so we can do some shooting after all. Did a lot more damage than I thought it would. Alright, shotgun time.
Do not warp the bullet.
I don't know how I missed the first one.
They're going after the weapons cache!
Excuse me, sir.
They're attacking the holy statues.
I don't suppose there's anybody else here who's gonna help me.
You are going to die!
They're attacking the monks! Get to the doors!
Well, that just seems rude. Oh, helicopter. Alright. Nobody's planting a bomb right this second. I gotta stop jumping off there. Oh boy, I'm dead. I'm trying to do like a sliding takedown, but I guess I can't. Okay, so let's do better this time. Don't have time to go all the way in there. Oh, there's a guy with a shotgun in front of me. Monk, who's there? I don't even know what that means. Oh, this one's turning orange, that's probably bad.
The
mines and stuff here.
The holy statues.
I forget how to put mines. I think it's like, yeah, zero. Helicopter gonna show up. I fucking walked off again. This works pretty well. I can't even tell what I'm shooting at, I'm just fucking shooting in this direction. The man counter says there's something over there. Alright, I think we're cool for a second. Never showed up, but I probably just didn't see it. Somebody's showed up. Alright. Crisis averted. I guess this was the first Far Cry game to introduce grappling, which was also in Primal.
Ajay, you see, this is what happens when people abandon religion, Ajay. It could have been so much worse. Thank you.
I feel like they didn't really tell me the motivation behind the father, but whatever.
Namaste.
Alright, new weapons. Yeah, yeah. A little late to tell me what karma is.
Sabal, the army attacked the monastery, but I drove them off.
Thank you, you were there, brother. That place is a symbol for our people. They need to see stability. Your father understood that. He could have used more men like you in the war.
Take that, you fucking death bird. Where did that bird land? Alright, well, that's pretty much Far Cry. I guess we'll do this tower, because that's another very Far Cry thing. But yeah, you know, it's like the other ones. Well, I mean, it's more like 3 than anything else, obviously, but it's, you know, I can see why some people say that this is the best of the post 3 Far Cries.
Ah, over there!
Obviously, some people are very particular to Blood Dragon, which I guess is also counted in there. Maybe this thing's far away than it looks. Let's get in the car to get away from this cat. Nope. Turn auto drive off. I forgot how to do that. I would like to actually do an experiment with the auto drive, though. Because basically, you set a waypoint, and then auto drive tries to bring you there. So I want to set a waypoint on like the other side of the map, and then just record what happens on the way to see if it actually makes it there, or you get rammed off the road. Because it's a pretty crazy driver when you let it do it. But yeah, so these towers are the same as they were in Far Cry 3, and so on and so forth. You get to the top, and then it marks a bunch of stuff on your map nearby. Same thing as the waypoints in Assassin's Creed. Not waypoints, but high points. At some point, Ubisoft decided that all of their games had to be basically just an amalgam of each other, which is why they all play pretty much the same. And it's not necessarily a good thing, because they're kind of formulaic and bland a lot of the time. But, you know, like, the basic gameplay here is good, so it's kind of alright that there's a lot of it. Trying to find the next way to climb up. Here we go. This game notifies climbing points with rope like that. Climbing rope. Where next? And I mean, this even leaked into non-Ubisoft games. You know, like, Dying Light had the exact same sort of climb towers to mark stuff thing. That said, Dying Light is a pretty good game. Which is surprising, considering it was made by the same developer as Dead Island. Because Dead Island is basically the way to make a super unenjoyable version of what Dying Light was. Seriously, I played through Dead Island like 3 times. It's a fucking terrible game. You know, it's fun to fuck around with friends in, but that doesn't make it a good game. I like drop this bell. We get a little fly through to all the nearby locations. Tiger. And yeah. So that's Far Cry 4. It does seem very much like the other Far Cries. And that's not necessarily a bad thing. It's fun. You know, when I want to just blow a couple hours shooting dudes and collecting stuff, this is what I do. It's a good game for listening to, like, a podcast while you knock out some of the side stuff. But I've been Shadefire. This is Far Cry 4, and I hope you'll join me again for some more stuff. Hopefully I'll get more, I'll end up playing more games where I can drive like a fucking moron. Because that's always fun. I don't think I've actually done an LP of a game that has driving as just a regular part of it.
You win this time.
Alright, I should probably stop here. Otherwise, I'm just gonna keep shooting men. Y'all all have yourselves a fine day.